This one welcomes you back. Heart of Mara, a bonus reward. A lovely prize. Wonderful. There are no crates remaining. Purchase more if you wish to try your luck again. Goodbye, my friend.
Thank you. Oi, Wanderer, you have some time? Welcome to the Prowl, friend. Lovely, eh? We sure could use some help to keep it that way. A bloody dragon swept through here recently. Can you believe that? Burned out a decent chunk of the Prowl and ate up the animals too. Now, a flock of poachers have moved in to kill the few beasts we have left. We could really use some help. Wait, does that mean you're in? Really? Zen's prize, that's good to hear. I work on a ranch east of here, just past the ridgeline. Talk to the owner, Numaya. She'll give you all the details and get you sorted. Thanks again, friend.
Hold there, poacher. One more step and my sweet boy will tear you apart. Come on, milksop. Get up. Ah, you're useless. Oh, I'm sorry. Numaya grows suspicious of everyone these days. A dragon swept through recently, you see. Gobbled up whole herds of antelope and burned out the larger hunting camps. Now bone-chime poachers pitch their tents all over the Prowl. We care for many rare animals. A juicy target, yes? Just yesterday, a group of them stole this one's training whistle to lure out our beasts, you see. We have little gold, but Numaya would pay you to retrieve her whistle and punish those muscarses. Oh, but this one would not give to see you kick those bone-chime bastards in the teeth. Unfortunately, Numaya cannot leave her beast unguarded. Life on the ranch has made them fat and lazy, especially this one. Yes, milksop, Numaya talks about you. Oh, yes. This one's mother's uncle's grandfather bought it from a wood elf tinsmith over 100 years ago. It's not flashy, no gold engravings or anything, but the tone it sings out is smooth and perfect as a topaz pearl, a masterpiece, Walker. Oh! This one does not like to think about it. Numaya has never seen something so fearsome. Toothy jaws, claws as long as grain size, and wings so wide they blot out the sun. Cinches and jackals we can handle. A beast like that, though? Oh, not a chance. It did. Horns, hoofs, tusk, and all. What it did not eat, it burned. Somehow, Numaya's ranch was spared. Praise Alkosh. Truly, this one thinks there's nothing on Nirni that can stop a monster like that. Beautiful, yes? Numaya bought this parcel from her always drunk Uncle Baraku. He was a talented hunter when he was sober. Alas, he was never sober.
Arvar, var.
You should have seen it before, Walker. Broken bottles, old ragged tents. Oh, hideous. Oh, yes. Numaya placed every board, hammered every nail, and drove every post. It took 6 years, but this one thinks it turned out all right. Truthfully, building it was not so hard. Rescuing these beasts, though. Oh, Zisfo, what a pain in the tail. Hunters, mostly. Well, Numaya should clarify. Careless hunters. Numaya does not fault Khajiit who eat meat. What makes this one snarl are Jacques-Khajiit, who strike beasts with an arrow and do not finish the job. Or trappers who never check their traps. Most. Numaya found Milksop half-starved in a dead fall pit. He frothed and roared at first, but now he just sleeps all day. Lazy, lazy, lazy! The monkey Marmalade nearly lost her hand to a snare. Sometimes this one wishes she had. She's so sneaky. Ooh. They are. But Numaya loves them anyway, even on their worst day. Animals love you no matter what. Only fair that we do the same for them, yes?
Thank you.
Thank the moons. Oh, you're back. Oh, the poachers. They took them. While you set fire to the poachers' camps, they launched a raid on the ranch. We tried to fight them off, but there were just too many of them. They took my sweet boy, Milksop, Honeydew, and Sugarbelly, too. Surrender cursed them! In lean times, they gather in the ruins to the west, along with their leader, Rati. You destroyed their smaller encampments, so they must be there. Most of the walls collapsed centuries ago, but the ones that still stand are mountain strong. Let me think. Ah, Marmalade, this one's pet monkey, not the preserve. She's very swift and very sneaky. If you use Numaya's training whistle, the one you just recovered, she might be able to help you. My best ranch hand, El Halem, will accompany you. He has sharp eyes and knows the prowl better than most. Oh, I hope we're not too late. If something happens to this one sweet boy, Milksop, oh, Numaya would never forgive herself. Well, it takes years to master whistle training, but Marmalade is very clever. If you find yourself blocked in the poacher's camp, just blow the whistle. She will find a solution. Don't expect too much of her, though. She's just a monkey, after all. Ah, this one wishes she could. Unfortunately, the poachers wounded many of my ranch hands and set fires all around. Numaya loves her animals, but she cannot let the entire ranch go up in smoke. El Halem will prove very useful, I promise. Well, it takes years to master whistle training.
Not a moment to lose, friend. Let's go save these animals. Hold on, Lavender. We'll get you out. She'll find her way home. We have more work to do. Honeydew! Bit high up, though. Maybe Marmalade can unlock it for us. Well done. Let's keep moving.
A land of heavy drinks and heavier regrets. Almost makes Rachin miss his days as a mortal. The hangovers, however, those he is happy to do without.
Door's locked, eh? Damn. Maybe Marmalade can fit through the crack there. Ha! She did it. The door's unlocked. Let's head in.
Ah!
Off with you, sugar belly. Now, another locked door, eh? I bet Marmalade could nick a key off that drunken guard. He's alive! Let's set him loose!
I am skin you alive!
That's all of them. Meet you back at the ranch, hero.
Oh, there's Numaya's favorite ranch hand. When Milksop and Sneaky Marmalade returned, this one knew you would not be far behind. Oh, they did. Numaya's sweet boy is a little shaken. Hopefully a hearty meal and a nice long chin scratch will settle his nerves, yes? You have this one's deepest thanks, Walker. Milksop's too. Say thank you, sweet boy. Go ahead now. Ah, never mind. Numaya wishes she could take a break, but stalls need raking, troughs need filling. Ugh, a rancher's work is never finished. From the poachers? Not long. From the dragon attack, though? You could say. Years? Your attacks on the poachers will allow honest, conscientious hunters to return to the prowl. With their help, we might be able to find a way to restore what we lost. Of course, Walker. There's nothing more wretched than a hunter with no beast to hunt. They will conserve what we have and protect what remains until the calves have calves. Only great fools would do otherwise, yes?
Thank you. Kill all interlopers! You'll make an excellent minion after I kill you!
Be still now. You must save your strength. You have come to Cicatris in a time of great danger, traveler friend. Toxic fumes permeate the air, and corpses walk among the ruins. It is best to turn away now before you share the fate of my dear companions. We were exploring the nearby Oasis Caverns when the fumes first began to spread. Only Najira and I were able to escape. The rest of my companions, weakened and disoriented by the poisoned air, ran farther into the caverns of the oasis. I would need to first create an antidote. However, I require samples from corpses that have absorbed the fumes. No easy task, given that something has awoken Cicatrice's dead. They now guard the ruins from any invaders. Thank you for the aid, traveler friend. The undead walk the ruins of Cicatrice. Directly to the west. I would advise caution. So much trouble for my Egg Mother's research notes. I now wonder if traveling to this town was the right decision. When we entered the caverns of the oasis, all seemed quiet. Then, suddenly, fumes began to surround us. The corpses which littered the ground sprang to life and attacked. Najira and I were the only ones able to escape. The fumes must have disoriented them, for they ran farther into the caverns. By the time we found the entrance, Najira could barely walk. Even I, blessed as I am with Argonian blood, began to feel weak. These fumes are most dangerous. Argonians have a far higher tolerance to poison than other races. Due to the nature of our homeland, that is why I was able to escape. But even so, it would be foolish to return to the oasis without first preparing. Precisely. An antidote will both allow us to enter the oasis safely and heal my companions of their weakness so that they may escape. That is why we must work quickly, traveler friend. When the Nahatan flu devastated Cicatrice, its people fled into the safety of the nearby oasis. They hoped that its healing waters could cure them of the disease. This effort was led by Nikusha, my egg mother. Yes, it is by her letters that I know of Cicatrice's suffering. She was a talented alchemist and hoped to develop a cure for the flu. However, this was many years ago. I do not believe she was successful. I hope to find my mother's research and share her findings. It's very likely she died here, trying to help those who had been so cruelly abandoned. Her great deeds should be shared with all of elsewhere. Once, the town of Cicatrice was a cool blessing within the scalding desert. The oasis beneath the town was clear, and many believed it had power to heal their ailments. The town prospered from these many visitors and the trade they bought. When the Nahatan flu came to elsewhere, many hoped that the oasis would heal them. They traveled here seeking hope, but brought their ailment with them. The town was quickly overcome with this sickness. Many died. They could not. The reigning monarchs quarantined infected towns in order to stop the disease from spreading. Cicatrice was eventually burned to the ground. And so, its people fled to the oasis. Their fate, however, is still unknown to me.
Tira will go alone. She will not sit idle while her friends suffer.
Please, don't be foolish. Najira, wait. I am glad to see you unharmed. Were you able to gather the samples? She fears for our companion's safety. I urged her to wait, for without an antidote she will quickly succumb to the fumes as well. But Najira refused to listen. I must begin my research. However, I still require a blossom of Arke's lash. A cactus with a bright pink flower. It has great medicinal properties. Would you collect a blossom for me? The cactus can be found west of here, in a small glade atop a crag. In the meantime, I'll begin to study the samples you brought. Thank you once more for your aid, traveler friend. After I create an antidote, we can enter the Oasis Caverns and rescue my companions. Perhaps even find my Egg Mother's research notes as well.
On my oasis! Leave this place! Now!
She's fine.
Fine.
should do it. My antidote is nearly complete. All I need now is the RK's Lash Blossom. Were you able to get one? A Nereid? Most peculiar. I wonder if she's somehow connected to the Oasis. But there is no time to speculate while my companions are still in danger. I must deliver this antidote to them. With luck, it will give them the strength to escape. Thank you, traveler friend. I feared to ask, but already you volunteer. Make sure to drink some of the antidote before entering the Oasis Caverns. And please, see if you can find my Egg Mother's research notes. My Egg Mother attempted to develop a cure for the Nahatan flu when it first struck Cicatrice. I am sure she kept meticulous notes about her progress. Such research will be vital to learning what happened here. Here you are, traveler friend. Let us hope this potion has the desired effect.